encourage your soul, enlighten your mind, and empower your faith. This is the Light Network.
If you want to be a serious Bible student, a successful servant, and a powerful preacher, this is the podcast for you. Hello and welcome to Preachers in Training. My name is Robert Hatfield, and this is the podcast where we talk about all things preaching and ministry. Welcome to Season 13, Episode 2. I'm excited about this episode because we're going to discuss a preview of the Fried-Hardeman University Annual Bible Lectureship. And there's nobody better to discuss that than with the one who directs that particular effort, Dr. Doug Burleson. Burleson is joining us today from the campus of Fried-Hardeman University. Welcome, sir. Welcome back. Glad you're here.
Hey, thanks for having me, Robert. It's great to see you.
I am excited about our conversation today, and we wanted to just take an episode to highlight the plans that you all have. Of course, this is the 85th annual Bible lectureship from Fried-Hardeman. The dates, by the way, February 7 to 11, 2021, coming up next month as we're releasing this. But admittedly, a little bit of a different format. Is this sort of the first time in history? I can't imagine that a few decades ago they were doing something like this. So there have been amendments to the schedule before, right? But the virtual aspect of this may be unique.
Yeah, you know, I think most years the weather maybe is our greatest concern, being in February. There were a few years because of wars or maybe going back to the Depression. I know early in its history, this month-long preacher training course that the lectureship came out of was postponed in part because of the Depression. So there have been some unique circumstances through the years, but never this started after the Spanish flu outbreak, you know, in 1918. And
yeah,
so
yeah.
Trying to think about how we put on a program that offers people what the lectureship always has offered, but in a way that keeps everybody safe, especially our campus community, required a lot of prayer and a little bit of creativity.
Creativity indeed. So I know that you've mentioned this, and maybe those, you know, we're preachers podcast here. Maybe the guys are in tune with the video that you and President David Shannon released in the fall. Maybe the guys who are listening to this are familiar with somewhat of the planning processes, but pretty much as soon as one lectureship ends, you all go into high gear for planning the year follow that is to come, right? And that's sort of the way this goes. So you had one lectureship entirely planned and almost before COVID even hit. Is that correct?
That's right. 3 weeks after the lectures, this really allows us to think about this in a fresh way and to look at the feedback, which we take very seriously. Most years we have about 50 pages, single spaced, small font, open comment feedback, and ways of measuring what people liked, what people didn't like. And so it's an opportunity for us to really jump on that early. And by the end of March, we had the whole program for 2021 planned, every speaker plugged in, because we usually take about a year to put a book together, to put out a magazine, to get the app ready. And so we were sitting on go and then hit pause when we realized there's a lot to think about. We saw other programs having to either cancel or postpone. And we saw it as an opportunity to not cancel, but to think about, okay, how could we offer something with all these variables that really we pray will bless those who are interested in studying the Word of God? And so had a whole program on He Went About Doing Good, Compassion of Christ in Luke, that we've now bumped to 2022. And we started thinking about what book would be good for us to study in light of these current circumstances.
That's exciting. So Luke, Lord willing, next year, 2022, describe for us where you're headed in 2021.
Well, thanks. You know, Ecclesiastes may be the most misunderstood book in the Bible other than Song of Solomon. And we're not doing a lectureship on that one anytime soon, I don't believe. So, you know, Ecclesiastes, I think a lot of people enjoy the conclusion of that 12-chapter book, but maybe in light of the questions that people have right now, we thought that sub-theme, finding meaning in a meaningless world, was particularly appropriate. Because even now, there are a lot of people who continue to put their faith in career or in finance or in even good things like family. And we just wanted to remind people that, as many of us have been reminded of over the last 10 months, you know, God is ultimately where we find purpose. And so we want to be true to the context of Scripture. I think one of the keys in Ecclesiastes is recognizing that important prepositional phrase, under the sun or under heaven, as a perspective that the preacher Solomon takes in that book. And so we believe, you know, part of what we try to do every year is evaluate how much of this can we take directly from the text, and then how can we make application from the text. And I'm really excited to see how not only the written program and the pre-recorded videos will feature this, but also some things we're doing on campus that week for students that will live stream, that also help us to engage the text of Scripture in a way that hopefully will help us grow and be thoughtful about showing the world hope, even when so many are struggling to do that.
This is really exciting. I want to talk in just a moment about how people will be able to consume the lectureship and participate in the program this year. But just what you're saying about the content itself is striking to me. I mean, clearly this is a response, as you just described, to the times in which we're living. But at the same time, it's sort of refreshing to hear that this isn't just going to be a whole lectureship series about COVID, you know, and how we've been there, we've done that. I'm sure it'll come up, and that seems appropriate. But even beyond that, you know, where is our trust? What is it that perhaps what we've experienced over the better part of last year is teaching us about our faith, or maybe where we need to strengthen our faith in some ways? It sort of seems like that's the direction where the program is going.
It really is. And I think part of what struck me as I've read the book, we finished proofing it last week, was the fact that only one writer mentioned COVID. Perhaps it's a reminder that circumstances are not what shape Christian character, right? It's God's character and what it is he desires for us to be. And so as our writers engaged wealth and relationships and all sorts of other themes that come up in Ecclesiastes, where the writer clearly has experienced everything there is to do under the sun, and says that at the end of the day, it's a relationship with God that provides hope. And so we're really hoping that this is something that will bless everybody that looks at the book or watches the videos or watches the live streaming from on campus that week or congregations, because Ecclesiastes offers a lot of hope, even though it's pessimistic wisdom as compared to Proverbs or some of the other books that we associate with Old Testament wisdom literature.
Even that vantage point almost seems appropriate coming off of 2020. Pessimistic wisdom.
That's right. I don't think there's a single lecture about masks. I'll just go ahead and throw that out there,
too. Oh, but that's a relief.
I think we've had enough of that whole debate, too.
We've heard those lectures, haven't we, on both sides. talk to us then about how we'll be able to participate. It sounds as though there's going to be a component of it that's happening live on campus. I understand that that needs to be limited in an effort to, as you all at Fried Hardeman are saying, protect the pride, and so we appreciate that. Maybe walk us through some of that, and then I'm sure there's an online component as well.
Well, I could talk about this all day, so I'll try to be concise, but if you visit the lectureship page on the Fried Hardeman University website, if you just go to fhu.edu/lectureship, you'll find there a number of things, including a way to pre-order the book. The book's $10. That includes tax, that includes shipping, and we'll be able to get that to you very quickly. This year, those books are being printed through the Kindle publishing feature of Amazon, and so they're printed on demand and shipped directly to you. They really are beautiful books. They're almost 300 pages in length, dedicated to Carrie and Lisa Couch and Stan and Marge Mitchell. There's some beautiful tributes to them in the book, as well as an article that Brother Stan wrote on the seasons of life from Ecclesiastes. So you can order the book, as many copies as you would like, for your congregation or just one for you. And then during the week of February 7th through the 11th, we'll be premiering actually 17 pre-recorded videos. Wow. There's a video for each of the 13 chapters in the book. And then there are four sessions for women that are also being pre-recorded because we did not want to forget about the valuable participation and contributions that our sisters in Christ make to our program every year. And then in addition to that, so let me back up. You can go there and you'll see a schedule where those videos will be premiered the week of the lectureship. And so on the night of the Super Bowl, our first video will premiere. Dr. Justin Rogers will be delivering that pre-recorded lesson. And then Monday through Thursday, there'll be three videos each day at 9:30, 1:30, and 7 p.m. We'll have a schedule there that you can see very shortly. And you'll note that as you look at that schedule, after those videos premiere, they'll be available on the website for you to view in your own time. And so if you're not able to watch that live, when it shows up on Facebook and YouTube and the Freed Hardeman website, you'll be able to go back and watch those whenever it's convenient for you. And then during the week, you can go to that same page, and we have a chapel series at 10:30 every day, and classes for women at 12:30, and then sessions at 2:30 and 3:30, and late that night at 10 p.m. That will be streamed throughout the day. And so we know there are a lot of things about lectureship that you just can't do virtually. Can't have a virtual coffee shop, although the associates, I'm sure, would love for you to order some of their FH brew. Can't have the vendor area where we just enjoy fellowshipping with each other, some of the networking that we do that week, finding interns. But we wanted to provide as much as we possibly could in this setting, with hopes that for our 86th lectureship in February 2022, we'll be back to be able to do the kinds of things that we all know and love with the lectures. So lots of ways to participate. You can always support the effort. We appreciate those sponsors who've already done that, but it's going to be a great week. Mm-hmm. To the glory of God, we pray.
This is really exciting. So social media channels, you just mentioned Facebook, YouTube. You'll be able to find the content there, according to at least those pre-recorded videos, right, that are going to come out.
Right.
And then fhu.edu/lectureship is really the place that people need to remember to go to get access to all the stuff, even including the live-streamed content, right, as well.
Everything will be there. And you can also go there if you want to reminisce about past programs, and you can find video and audio recordings of lectures from the last 5 or 6 years that are also there. And so if there's a speaker who's not on the program this year that you'd like to hear again, all those archive sessions are there in one convenient place as well.
Very cool. All right. So at the time that we're recording this, and this may change by the time it's released, but the schedule is not uploaded on the website. We're recording this at the end of December in 2020. So you can go there. You can see that schedule to get those times. There's a chapel series. There are afternoon live stream lectures. And, of course, then that pre-recorded. Is that kind of like the keynote, I suppose, the pre-recorded
lessons? Yeah, and what we wanted to do was to complement the book with those 13 lessons. And so Hiram Kemp, Dan Winkler, Jeff Jenkins, Ralph Gilmore, a lot of folks that you will know and love who are participating in that, Billy Smith, Jim Gardner. And so I hope that everybody can find those with or without the book. It'll be content that's slightly different from the written material. But we just wanted to make sure that people were able to get fed, which is part of what we enjoy doing every February.
That's really neat. By the way, Hiram Kemp, Dan Winkler, two of our hosts here on the Light Network. So I know listeners of TLN will want to check them out as well. Now's the time to pre-order the book, right? So if you haven't done it yet, head over to that website so that you make sure that you have the book in time. Perhaps there'll be a complement, as you just said, between the written material and the presented material on the internet. So that's an important thing, too. $10. How many pages did you say that book is, by the way?
Almost 300.
Wow.
Almost 300.
And this is, to be clear, I misunderstood at the beginning before we hit the record button. I said, that's just a digital copy, right? You said, no, that's a legitimate physical copy book fulfilled through Amazon that comes to your door. That's amazing.
Well, we really wanted it to be affordable. You know, we've had some congregations already order bulk copies, 50, 100 copies, something like that. And so we wanted to make sure, you know, that as with any curriculum, as with any opportunity, that this was more about serving the kingdom than making a profit. Mm-hmm. And so we're covering cost, the lectureship, runs off of the generous support of a lot of people who just want to support Fried Hardeman. And so we thought this book could be one way that people could benefit, especially since we can't be all here in person together. So we're really excited about this being in people's hands.
Mm-hmm. There have been, just a brief aside, there have been some events, even since COVID, that have annual events that have been able to take place on campus. And the video at fhu.edu/lectureship sort of explains some of this. The student body was not on campus when those events took place. And so the reason, I don't want to put words in you guys' mouth, but the reason why the lectureship is not taking place on campus as usual is because the student body is present. Is that a good way of kind of describing that?
Yeah, it really is. I mean, compared to graduation events or the benefit dinner, or even summer camps, even though we had challenges all summer with those events as well. We really just want to put students first. And the lectureship is for them and for everyone else who's able to come to campus. And so we wanted to clarify from the very beginning that we're not canceling the lectureship. We've planned two programs, really, since last February. But we are trying not only to protect our students, but a vulnerable population of people who come to campus every year. And you know, there are varying opinions about this. Some of us, I've had COVID, all four of our kids have been through this too. We just didn't want to put anybody in a position where they were having to choose between their own personal health and safety and, you know, the lectureship. And we wanted students to be safe as well. And so I appreciate very much the way that President Shannon and his cabinet, the lectureship committee, really a number of leaders came together, and there was consensus that we just needed to put other people first. You know, the lectureship was made for man, not man for the lectureship. And so we got to keep first things first. And as important as a week that is for all of us, I feel that as much as anybody. We're looking forward to a great week, although it'll be a little different than it has been for the last 84 years.
FHU.edu/lectureship is the place to go for the 2021 lectureship, Encountering Ecclesiastes, Finding Meaning in a Meaningless World. The dates for that, February 7th through 11th, 2021. And consequently, since you have already planned the lectureship that is to follow that one, then you also know that you're going to be studying Luke in 2022, the Lord willing, and that's the week of February the 6th, right? I know you guys announced already the theme, and of course the date pretty much stays the same each time, but so that's exciting too. We got a little preview of what's coming up a little earlier than maybe we anticipated.
You know, it's really easy, I think, for me to look back at this year and talk about things that have not gone as planned, but there's some good things that have come out of this, and one of the things that we hope to do is to stay a year ahead and to also be able to tweak parts of the program that don't always get as much attention as we would like because we're so busy putting together the sessions and contacting speakers and making the book. So there are four or five significant things that we've had time to evaluate that I think coming back in 2022 will be as strong as ever, if not better, because we've had more time to pray about it and plan for it. And so, as excited as I am about 2021, I mean, my first year of directing back in 2016, we did the Gospel of Mark. One of my favorite lectureship memories from Dr. David Leip's years of directing the program was the series we did on the Gospel of John. Anytime you get to focus on the Lord and a gospel account, it's going to be a great study together in February of 2022 as well.
Yeah, that's neat. Fried Hardeman University Lectureship, the annual Bible lectures, is just a wonderful, top-notch program, and it's evident that you all are iterating and tweaking and improving each year, and I enjoyed it as a student some 10-plus years ago and continue to enjoy it now. I think I enjoy it more today than I did then, and I think part of that's maturity, maybe 90%, but the rest is certainly that The program has it's just wonderful, and it's clear that you all are putting in a lot of effort in a lot of different ways to make it, true to the heritage, but also to continue to minister to the culture and to the times, and that means a whole lot too. So thank you for that, and we're very much looking forward to next month and the lectureship at that point. Appreciate it.
Hey, well, thank you. I'll just add one thing, if that's okay.
Please.
Our students here are huge supporters of the lectureship every year. Mm-hmm. And just as an example of that, our Student Government Association actually planned our late night lecture series. They've been doing that for several years, but in doing so, made a formal request that their classes be dismissed if there's ever a lecture at that time. And it may be that we hear that and say, well, of course they would want their classes to be dismissed. But with sincerity, they have, it's just been amazing to see how students have really shifted their schedules and prayerfully supported and participated in. I mean, every year we have a teen lectureship and a kids program that our students basically equip. And even though we can't do that in 2021 to the same degree, you know, we wanted to make sure that they know that just because we can't have off-campus guests here doesn't mean we're not going to have a lectureship on campus that week. Mm-hmm. So it's a blessing to see how this program, we pray, not only blesses Fried Hardeman, but also the Brotherhood and the students who are here now. And we know that there are lots of great programs like this that happen around the year. And it's our prayer that those programs can continue to thrive and we can all get back to doing what we want to do in the ways we want to do them and count our blessings in these times of transition rather than just focusing on the negatives. That's what we are hoping to do in February.
Well, I remember when you were on last season and you helped us to navigate. If memory serves, I think we talked about maybe self-care during this coronavirus pandemic and all of that as ministers. And you emphasized then, too, and it was fresher then, of course, than it is even now, but positivity through this and emphasizing positivity even among the congregation, you know, as we're speaking with the congregation that we get to serve. And I appreciate that perspective, too, with this. And it sounds like it's actually going to produce some really neat possibilities and opportunities that wouldn't have existed otherwise, even for the lectureship program. So that's pretty neat.
It's amazing how these things cause you to rethink the way you do what you do. And sometimes that is positive growth. And for us, thinking about who we can reach online around the world, we know that not everybody can take off that week and come to campus on a regular basis anyway. And so it's caused us to rethink the way we do the book. And I think there'll be some really positive things that are evident when people get this in their hands. We'll still do a Q&A session every afternoon at 3:30, kind of like the forum, except students will be the ones mainly asking those questions in real time. And so as we think about next year, it's really a blessing to consider, okay, how can we do this in a better way? And I appreciate the shoulders that we stand on and the traditions that we've inherited, but being able to reevaluate that annually, keep it fresh, you know, while keeping it strong in the faith. That's our balance we're striving for.
Wow. I love that. So as we're watching, it could be that there are, you know, people that are there, and those will mostly be students, maybe other members of the Fried Hardeman community and family that are a part of that. And so that'll be really neat too. So we shouldn't be surprised when we're watching this and there are people maybe as a part of some audience, right?
Yeah, we've really had to, even with our local community, so many Christians here in Chester County.
Yeah.
We're just having to be really careful and thoughtful about the way that we protect our students and our faculty and our staff. And so we hope, you know, to be hospitable. That's one of our goals that week. There'll be some live interactions as well with President Shannon and others, just communicating to those who are watching online how much they mean to us as well, just as if we were all sitting in the same room. And so, yeah, students, we pray we'll embrace all of these opportunities. Their Bible classes will be dismissed that week during those times as a way of allowing them opportunity to participate.
Yeah, that's wonderful. So as we sort of wrap things up, if there's anything else that you'd like to share, we'd love to hear that. I'm thinking about, we're talking primarily to preachers and ministers here. If you're not a preacher or minister, you're welcome to listen anyway. Don't feel like you've violated any rules or anything. But what would you say to preachers and other ministers, maybe a word of encouragement about what to expect from the lectures or even just to participate virtually? I'm looking forward to kind of having it on, even as I'm studying and maybe, you know, sort of participating in those ways as well. Want to know what encouragement you'd like to offer to them, and then whatever else you'd like to add as we conclude today.
It's amazing how diverse an experience people have at a program like this, because some people go and they're just looking to visit with friends. It's like a family reunion. Others go and they take notes away and plan preaching for a full year. I received a letter from an individual last year after our program who went home and basically preached the rest of the year on the stuff he had heard while he was here. And so When I think about the lectureship, I just view it as an opportunity for preachers and teachers to come and to be refilled, to be encouraged, to be challenged. As we were putting together these lessons, we wanted to make sure not only was there a lot of exegetical strength involved, but a lot of applications. I think you'll hear it in the lessons and see it in the book. Not only are there discussion questions at the end of each chapter, but there are lots of illustrations, ways of reinforcing this, these principles, because we understand that preaching is bridge building, and it begins with a strong foundation in the text, exegesis, but then it needs to move to application. And I think sometimes, especially with Ecclesiastes, that's the struggle. We might think that it's either too pessimistic or it's too tied to the historical life of Solomon to really be applicable. And so I would just encourage you to, we're all busy, but take advantage of the opportunity to participate in the lectureship, even in your pajamas. You know, take advantage of the opportunity to really have your cup refilled and to sit with some men who have studied this material. If you're a woman in faith who wants to engage in study, not only are there the four pre-recorded sessions, but there are four more Bible classes for women during the week, live streamed at 12:30 each afternoon. And so even though we can't do everything we normally do, this is something that we want to serve the church, and we want people to love the Lord. And if we ever fail to do that, then we really miss the point. And so even in Ecclesiastes, we can see God's goodness, even in the midst of the election transitions and the pandemic and murder hornets and whatever else we're worried about, there's good news to be found. And so a challenging book, a challenging time, but a great God. And we pray a great program that will encourage everybody who participates.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Dr. Doug Burleson serves as Associate Professor in Bible at Freed Hardeman, and also, of course, the Director of the Annual Bible Lectureship. Thank you for being a part of our program today, and we're excited. Thanks you and the Lectureship Committee and all of you for planning this for us and even iterating it for a primarily virtual setting. Thanks for everything. We greatly appreciate all you do.
Well, thank you, Robert. Appreciate your friendship. Appreciate your great work, not only here on the podcast, but in the kingdom. And prayers for a great year serving our God together.
Absolutely. And thank you for being a part of our podcast today. Remember, brand new episodes of Preachers in Training release every Thursday from our website, thelightnetwork.tv. Watch on YouTube or listen and subscribe anywhere podcasts are obtained. Just search for Preachers in Training and hit that subscribe button. You can help us out by leaving a rating and review as well in your podcast app of choice, and that'll help us spread the word not only about this podcast, but the Light Network at large. Thanks so much for being a part of our episode today. Until next time, I'm Robert Hatfield. Let's go preach the word.